friends. Welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous video, we have already discussed the basic terms and definitions of lines and angles. Today, we will solve some questions related to these terms and definitions. Let's start with our first question. Identify the given figures by looking at them. Friends, look at the first figure. Here, on both the sides, there is a symbol of an arrow, and this shows that it can be extended further in both directions. Therefore, this is a line, line AB, and we represent it like this. Look at the second figure. Here on one end is a point, and on the other end there is a symbol of an arrow, that is, it can be extended further in only one direction. So this is a ray PQ, and we represent it like this. In the third figure, here on both the ends, there is a point. This can be part of any line, so we call it a line segment. This is line segment MN, and we can represent it like this. In this figure, an angle is given, angle ABC, and by looking at it, we can easily say that its measure is less than 90 degrees. Therefore, angle ABC is an acute angle. Friends, in the next figure also, an angle is given, angle PQR, and its measure is more than 180 degrees. Therefore, we can say that this angle is a reflex angle. Let's move ahead and see the second question. Define the given angles along with the figure. First of all, complementary angles, whose definition is like this. If the sum of two angles is 90 degrees, then we call such angles as complementary angles. For example, look at this figure. In angle XYZ, the measure of angle XYW is 30 degrees and the measure of angle WYZ is 60 degrees. On adding the two, we get 90 degrees, that is, these two angles are complementary angles. Now let's see the definition of supplementary angles. If we obtain the sum of two angles as 180 degrees, then we call such angles as supplementary angles. Look at the figure. In angle PQR, the measure of angle PQT is 60 degrees and the measure of angle TQR is 120 degrees. On adding the two, we get 180 degrees, so we can say that angle PQT and angle TQR are supplementary angles. Now let's see the definition of vertically opposite angles. When two lines intersect each other, then the vertically opposite angles are formed. Like here, line AB and line CD are intersecting each other at the point O. As a result, we get two pairs of vertically opposite angles. The first pair is angle AOC and angle BOD, and the second pair is angle AOD and angle COB. That's all in this session. Today, we saw some questions and answers related to the basic terms and definitions of lines and angles. See you in the next video. Thank you.